So hi everyone, we discussed about heat topic up to activity number 4, which means in activity number 4, what is activity number 4? Taking a lid and taking a beaker. Now pour some water in the beaker, find the initial temperature in the beaker of the water. Now pour some oil on the beaker. What will happen? Oil will float on the beaker. Why? Because the water, the density of water is more by comparing to the density of the oil. With that reason, the oil will float on the beaker. Now place another thermometer in the oil. Now find the initial temperature of the oil. What will happen? Just note down the initial temperature of oil as well as initial temperature of the water. Now heat up the water by using burner. After some time, water will be heated and rise this temperature in the water, and even oil is also heated up. Now the change in the temperature in oil as well as water, note down the both the temperatures. Now find the difference between the temperatures of oil as well as water, the time taken by the time taken to rise the temperature in water as well as oil. Both the we need to compare. That is the activity number 4. This is the specific heat as well as activity number 5. What is activity number 5 means? In activity number 5, same, considering a beaker, in a beaker completely filled with water, Now this water is completely filled with water. Now just find the note down the initial temperature in the beaker. Initial temperature in the beaker by using thermometer. Now take two identical test tubes. One is completely filled with water and another one is completely filled with oil. Of same densities, okay, of same mass. One is completely filled with water. This is filled with water and this is filled with oil. Now place a thermometer inside the water as well as oil. Okay. This is T2, this is T1, thermometer 1 and thermometer 2. Now note down the initial temperatures in test tube 1 as well as test tube 2. Okay. In temperature, initial temperatures in test tube 1 as well as test tube 2. Now note down the initial temperatures. After that, what will happen? Now by using burner, just heat up the test tube or beaker. Okay. Now by using burner, just heat up the beaker. Now what will happen? Water will be boiled. Okay, water will be boiled by using this water heat as well as this water test tube as well as oil test tube. Both will be heated up. But comparing to the test tube of water, oil will be, the change in the temperature in thermometer 2 is more while comparing to the change in the temperature in thermometer 1. Why? Because water will take more time to heat, but oil will take less time to heat. Why? Because density of the oil is very less while comparing to the density of the oil. That is why reason it is called specific heat. I hope you understand the activity number 5. Okay. Now, in this only, activity number 6. What is activity number 6? Is The activity number 6 is completely basing on specific heat only. Now we need to consider two beakers. Okay, we need to consider two beakers. This is beaker number 1 of water, 80 grams of water or 200 grams of water. In this 200 grams of water, it is 250 grams of water in beaker 1. This is B1 and this is 1 liter or 1 kg of water. This is 1 kg of water in beaker 2. Okay. Now heat up these two water beakers by using a burner. Now heat up these two water beakers by using a burner. What will happen? There is a rise in temperature. First of all, we need to find the initial temperature of beaker 1 as well as initial temperature of beaker 2 before heating. Okay, I just forgot that we need to find initial temperatures of thermometer 1 as well as thermometer 2. Now heat up the substances which is present in the beaker. What will happen? The temperature, rise in temperature T1 is more by comparing to the rise in temperature in T2. Why? Because the water which is present in beaker 1 is very less, which means 250 grams only. So it will rise in temperature is high by comparing to 1 kg of water. 1 kg of water means it is quantity of water is more while comparing to the beaker 1. Here beaker 1, in beaker 1 quantity of water is very less. Here quantity of water is more. That's why it will take less time to rise in temperature. It will take more time in rising temperature. If we express that part in mathematical expression, how we can write it as here, generally heat we can say Q is amount of heat, okay, M is mass of an object or amount of mass of water, okay, and delta Q or delta T is change in temperature, and T is the temperature. Okay, T is temperature. Now, if we write the mathematical expression, then Q is always directly proportional to M, which means Q is always directly proportional to mass of a substance. Okay, so Q is always directly proportional to amount of substance. So Q is directly proportional to M, and in bracket delta T is constant. Okay, delta T is constant. Taken this one as equation 1. Now, okay, now in 1 liter water beaker, what will happen? Change in temperature we observe in 1 liter water beaker. Change in temperature is Q directly proportional to delta T. Okay, Q is directly proportional to delta T. Here M is constant, and take this one as equation 2. Now equate this equation 1 and 2. Okay, now equate this equation
1 and 2.
Now,
equate that equations 1 and 2.
From equation 1 and 2, from equation 1 and 2,
so write it.
What is equation 1? Q directly proportional to M is equation 1. Q directly proportional to delta T. So equation 1 and 2.
Q equal to
M S delta T, where S is constant. Okay. S is constant of the specific heat. Okay.
Constant of specific heat. Now what will happen? We can write this one as, bring as this said, so S equal to Q by M delta T is the equation. S equal to Q by M delta T. This is the fraction of the equation. This is the specific heat gradient or specific heat. We know this one as a specific heat gradient or specific heat. Now, the units of specific heat is SI unit of specific heat. Okay, SI unit of specific heat is joule per kg Kelvin. Okay, joule per kg Kelvin, as well as CGS unit is calorie per gram centigrade. Okay, so this one calorie per gram centigrade, you can write it as one kg Kelvin. Okay, this is also term we can write, as well as this term we can write as 4.186 into 10 to the power joule per kg Kelvin. Okay, this is all about specific heat and the equation we are getting from the specific heat. Okay. Next, applications of specific heat. What are the applications of specific heat? We can say simplest applications of specific heat is, sun which is present high amount of heat energy. Otherwise, you can say in sun high amount of heat energy is present. When these heat rays or sun rays falls on the earth, these rays are stored in the oceans. These oceans are used to store as bodies for the sun rays. And next one, if we consider a samosa, if we observe the samosa outside, it looks like cool, but while comparing to the outside, if you open the inside of the samosa, the curry is so hot. Because the ingredients which are present in the samosa keep that heatness in the inside the object. This is the applications of specific heat. Okay, these are the applications of specific heat. As well as watermelon, one more example you can say watermelon is also, if we keep watermelon inside the fridge, now remove after some time, take the watermelon from the fridge and cut the watermelon pieces, what we will feel, after some time also, that watermelon will be in cool position only. Why? Because the substances which is used to keep inside the water balloon is cool only. Okay, that are the specific heat, which means either it can be used in cooling process as well as it can be used in heating process. This is about specific heat as well as application for specific heat. Now, method of mixtures. Now, method of mixtures. In this method of mixtures, take situation one. Okay. Situation one is in method of mixtures. Situation one is take two beakers. Considering two beakers. Okay, considering two beakers. One beaker is filled with small amount of water, which is, for example, it is 80 grams of water in this 500 grams of water. Now heat up these two beakers. By using burner. Okay. By using thermometer, just find the temperatures which is present in beaker one as well as beaker two. After some time, just observe the difference between temperatures in beaker 1 and beaker 2. After some time, what we need to do one more thing. After this beaker, we need to fill up this water. This two beaker water, pour into a large beaker. Okay? This two beaker water is filled with large beaker and find the temperature which is present in this third beaker or big beaker. What will happen? The temperature will be changed in the thermometer. This is the situation one. Okay? Which means method of mixtures. So next topic is principle of method of mixtures. Okay, principle method of mixtures. In this principle method of mixtures, we have three situations. Situation one is basing on two beakers. I am writing here. Situation one. In situation one, we are consider two beakers. Okay, I am writing here. Consider two beakers. Okay, consider two beakers which are of same size. Okay, which are same size. Example, I am drawing here. Both are of same size only. Now heat up the water. Now pour water into the beakers. By using burner, heat up the beakers. Okay, by using burner, heat up the beakers. After some time, they will attain. Before heating up, just measure the temperature in both the beakers by using thermometer and then heat up the beakers by using burner. After some time, they will attain, both the beakers attain some temperature, same temperature. Okay. Now what will happen? Next is add these two beakers of water into a large beaker. Okay. Add these two beakers of water into a large beaker. I am writing here. Add these two beakers
of water into a large beaker. What will happen? So there is a change in the temperature. When adding these two beakers of water into a large beaker, there is a change in the temperature. That change in the temperature we are observing, and we are mostly thinking about the water. We are adding the substances, but what is here? We are mixing more than one or two different temperatures of water into a beaker. Okay, this is the situation one. Now coming to, but here in these two beakers of same size, from next situations, the size of the beaker is same, but quantity of water will change. From the from in beaker 1 we will consider 90 ml, and beaker 2 we will consider 200 ml, and we will heat up to 60 degree centigrade as well as 90 degree centigrade. By adding these two beakers of water into a large beaker, what will happen? Okay, like this situation 2 will change. So in situation 2, we are considering two beakers. In situation 2 also, considering two beakers of, considering two beakers of, one beaker is with same water, okay, both will be same quantity of water only, but this water will be heated up to 90 degree centigrade in beaker 1. It is burner. Okay. So in beaker 1 it was heated up to 90 degree centigrade. In beaker 2 it was heated up to 60 degree centigrade. Okay. Now add these two beakers of water into a large beaker. What will happen? There will be a change in the temperature of the water. Why? Because here it is 90 degrees, here it is 60 degrees. So when combining these two temperatures, what will happen? It will become as 150 degree centigrade in both the beakers as a large beaker. Okay, in the large beaker it will become more temperature while comparing to separate beakers. In situation 3, it is 100 ml of water and it is 200 ml of water of 90 degree centigrade as well as 60 degree centigrade. Now placing in large beaker, again we combining these two beakers of water into a large beaker, then there is a change in the quantity of the water as well as change in the temperature of the water. So finally it will become, quantity it is 300 ml as well as change in the temperature is 150 degree centigrade. Okay, so in large beaker it will become as 150 degrees centigrade. If we consider as the amount of heat in the simple example for this situation only, what is happening there? Heat is lost by the beakers. We are considering heat is lost by the beakers. So the heat lost by the water body, water sample Q1, is, we can take it as ms of T1 minus T. Okay. So next step, the amount of heat gained by the amount of heat gained by the cooler body is Q2 is
m2 s of p minus p2. Now add these equations, okay? So assuming loss of heat, assuming loss of heat q1 equal to q2. So I am writing both the equations at a time. So m1 s of t 1 minus t equal to m2 s of t minus t2. So if we take t common, capital T, okay, t equal to m1 of t1 plus m2 of t2 by m1 plus m2 is the equation what the amount of heat gained by the cooler body, okay, what the heat gained by the cooler body. Now if we go detailedly explanation about principal method of mixture, means there is a simple definition for this one. I'm writing that one, just observe this. Observe that definition, okay? When two or more bodies at different temperatures are brought together into thermal contact then net heat lost by hotter bodies is equal to the net heat gained by the cooler bodies, okay, net heat gained by the cooler bodies until they attain thermal equilibrium, okay, until they attain thermal equilibrium. So it can be write as net heat loss equal to net heat gain, net heat loss equal to net heat gain, okay? This is known as principle of method of mixtures, okay? So up to here we completed our our topic in heat. From tomorrow we will continue about the remaining activities which is present on evaporation, boiling, melting, freezing, condensation, as well as fog, dew, humidity. All these topics tomorrow we will continue. So up to here we completed, and prepare for the exam, wrote it well, and prepare, perform the exam very well, okay? Thank you.